Those who stumble upon the most diverse square block in Denver must find themselves wondering if they are, in fact, in Denver. For more than a year, 9 News photojournalist Corky Scholl has quietly chronicled the comings and goings of a park that has turned into more than just a safe haven for a group of the city's most vulnerable newcomers. 9 News reporter Chris Vanderveen brings us the story of new freedom in East Denver.
By its very definition, there is a stigma attached to the word foreign.
There's too many people that drive by these communities and don't even know what they are.
Yet in this one square block of East Denver,
to the front, to the back, to the seesaw side, to the front,
camaraderie is the byproduct of what outsiders might consider strange and unfamiliar.
And where did they live? Do you remember?
10 ethnic groups call the Grace Apartments home. Here, when the melting pot simmers, you smell it.
A lot of times it's curry, sometimes you can smell coconut milk in the air. One of our biggest concerns is that the kids are in the alley and in the parking lot.
90% of the children here are children of refugees.
It's wonderful that they enjoy playing outside, but of course it's not safe.
It's why early last year, the Trust for Public Land offered this land as a way to literally get children off of the streets and alleys.
It is not safe to play outside on the street.
Just as nearby Westerly Creek continued to flow, so in turn did progress on the park.
It has been a long time, but I am very grateful for having this park right now.
Gracias very much.
When it and the community garden finally opened, a once forgotten square block of land quickly became a home away from the cruel home of yesterday.
Man, where are you going, man?
On any given weekend,
get back here.
The appropriately named New Freedom Park welcomes a crowd as diverse as any World Cup match.
He's from Senegal, he's from Nepal, he's from Sweden. Where are you from?
Burundi.
He's from Burundi, I'm from Nepal, and he's from Mexico.
Do the Burmese soldiers give you problems?
Yeah.
In your village?
Yeah.
They do?
They do.
Frank Anello works with people who are not far removed from refugee camps.
I was one of the unaware people. I was living right down the street from them and drove by this intersection time and time again and didn't know anything about it.
He says the park symbolizes something that can't be confined to one square block.
Instead of isolating the different groups, it brings everybody together. Kids don't care about where they're from. They just want to play together.
There is no racism here. Everybody loves each other, you know.
Yet, sometimes even life in a foreign land carries with it all too familiar risk.
On behalf of the city, our deepest condolences.
Earlier this year,
someone knows what happened here.
A refugee from Burma lost her two boys less than a block away from New Freedom.
So I challenged the person that was driving the car that night to have the courage to come forward.
A hit and run.
And a moment of silence for their mother. Keep her in our prayers that she recovers.
The driver remains unknown.
Go away, come again another day. Daddy want to play. Rain, go away.
Not that it will keep a Burmese father like Kai Chit from coming back.
Here, I'm a free.
This park is far removed from a refugee camp in Thailand.
And where did you meet this lady?
This lady, I met her in Rangoon.
In Rangoon. And your life changed forever.
Yeah.
So you're giving your daughter a lot different life than what you had.
Happy birthday to you.
The stigma we far too often attach to the word foreign ignores the simple fact that in the end, no matter the home from whence we came, We all share something universal. Fathers like Kai will always carry a soft spot in their heart for their daughters.
Who's up here? It's core.
Nice foot.
And children will always look for a nearby place to play.
It is fantastic. It is.
Mark. Put him on pressure.
In a land of new freedom.
It's core.
That is hardly a foreign concept.
Yeah. New freedom for every group that lives in this area. People who thought they'd never see freedom ever again.
With photojournalist Corky Schultz.
Yeah, it's pretty awesome.
Chris Vanderveer, 9 News.
Mercy Housing runs the Grace Apartments that border New Freedom Park. The park itself sits on 2 acres of land. Because so many languages are spoken there, the design process was a little tricky at first, but it was always critical to get the input of the community before going ahead with that plan.